Hello and a very warm welcome to the Gangwon Ice Arena in Gangwon. It's day two of the short track speed skating competition here at the Youth Winter Olympics. Well, we had such drama yesterday in the 1500 meters for men and women. Today, we shorten the distance. It goes down to 1000 meters. And the one guarantee I'm going to give you is there's going to be just as much drama today. Here's our schedule. We'll start off with the heats, first for the women, then the men. We will trim that down to quarterfinalists, semifinalists, and we will conclude with A and B finals, first for the women, then for the men. So a lot to get through and a lot of exciting action to look forward to as well. Yesterday, our podium was dominated by skaters from Asia. It's historically a competition that began in 2012, and it's been dominated by two nations. The hosts here, the Republic of Korea, and the People's Republic of China. Between them, they have claimed 26 of the 32 medals available, with Hungary, Japan, and Canada getting a couple each. Guess what? Yesterday, there were three medals for the People's Republic of China, two for the Republic of Korea, and a bronze in the women's 1500 meters for Japan as well. So the dominance continues. But will things change today? Because we've got a very exciting looking lineup. Later on, we'll be seeing the men. And we will begin with the women's heats. And all the skaters that we saw in action yesterday in the 1500 meters will be in action here. The slate has been wiped clean. It's a fresh start. And again, really good to see plenty of support in the arena for these teenage athletes, future superstars here. And for others, this will be the culmination of their sporting careers. But for all of them, this is an occasion they will never forget. And I think for these skaters as well, probably not quite as many nerves and butterflies fluttering around as this time yesterday, when it was an introduction to competition for the first time for real. Well, they know about themselves, they know about their opponents, they know about this rink, as we take a look now at our first heat. And it's a good one, with Kang Min-ji, Eliza Rode-Hamel of the United States, Birgit Rat of the Netherlands, and Pumprida Premprecha of Thailand. Kang won the B final. Rode-Hamel failed to qualify. Rat was very unfortunate to crash out in the quarterfinals. And Premprecha had a great skate in the quarterfinals, then got run out of it in the semifinals. That, of course, over the 1,500 meter distance. So down to 1,000 now. That will favour the more powerful skaters who've got the burst. And as Eliza Rode-Hamel was saying, her favourite is the 500 meters, because you don't even have time to think. In the 1,500 metres, there was tactics, there was strategy, there were things going on. Whereas when it's the shorter distances, and as I say, we'll be down to 500 on day three of the competition, but sometimes you just have to put your head down and go flat out. But it will be Kang Min-ji of the host nation, number 19 there, who will be favoured to come out of this heat. And qualification is tough. It's really tough. There are going to be a number of heats. Most will feature four skaters. There's one, I think, will feature three skaters. That, of course, is assuming everybody has stayed healthy after yesterday. We may have some late replacements. And it's very simple. Top two, you'll advance to the next phase. Beyond that, it's luck of the draw. And there will only be two third-place finishes available for the two fastest third places. So these skaters know they can't even think like that. They've just got to get in the top two. So it's the Republic of Korea, the United States, the Netherlands, and Thailand to get this party started.
Go to the start. Ready.
Day two at the short track speed skating then, and we are underway with our first heat in the women's 1,000 metres, and it's Rat of the Netherlands who will lead Premprecha of Thailand around this first bend. Kang of the Republic of Korea, as we saw in the heats yesterday, the skater with the strong burst tends to sit at the back, wait to see what unfolds, then they attack. Rhode Hamill of the United States taking a position as well, and they've dropped the Thai, who has dropped down to fourth, and Kang has decided, now time for me to hit the front, and let's take everybody around with me. Rhode Hamill from Madison, Wisconsin, tucked in second place. Rutt trying to hold her place for the Netherlands in third, and Prem Preacher sitting at the back, and I'm not sure that's where she wants to be. And she's setting a hot pace here, Kang Min-ji. I mean, she's not hanging around as we get down to less than four laps to go. Remember, only two will go through as of right. And this looks like it's going to be a blanket finish, but Kang looks like she's got plenty in the tank. Happy front running, taking Rhode Hamill around with her, who's skating very sensibly, but she's going to have to watch what might come from Birgit Rutt, who's in third place, and Prem Preacher, the Thai skater, looks to be out of this as we get down to the business end of things here, and it is Kang that continues to set the hot pace. No move yet from Rutt in third place. Rhode Hamill will be aware that she's there, but Rutt could not make a move, and so it's Kang and Rhode Hamill that will advance to the quarterfinals. Comfortable there for Kang Min-ji. I think he's still disappointed that she failed to qualify for the A final yesterday. Winning the B final, scant consolation for her. Her sights are set much, much higher, and she would have expected to breeze through this opening heat, and that's exactly what happened. And Eliza Rhode Hamill, the one-time figure skater turned speed skater, with a very, very sensible skate as well. But once Kang decided to make that move, Rhode Hamill stuck with her, just aware that Birgit Rutt was behind her. But there was no chance for the Dutch skater to attack. And in the end, it was a bit of an anticlimax because it was very comfortable for the leading two. No photo finish. And it's Kang and Rhode Hamill that we will see in the quarterfinal. Confirmation then. Nothing for the referee to look at either. And with only two third-place fastest finishers available, Birgit Rutt will have to just sit and wait. So first heat is officially in the record books. And the action just comes thick and fast because we'll be on to heat number two next. With Sonia Stoyanova representing Bulgaria, there will be another host nation skater in this, in Chung Chae-hee, who made that final and crashed out. She'll be the strong favourite here, with three European skaters facing her. Cornelia Wozniak, the flag bearer in the opening ceremony for Poland, Kamila Salmina and Sonia Stoyanova of Bulgaria on the outside. Well, let's see if Chung decides to hit the front right from the get-go here and take the field round with her. I wouldn't be surprised if that's what happens. That's exactly what's happened here. It'll be a battle for second spot. Wozniak has the pedigree, but it's Kamila Salmina, the Latvian, who decides to have a look and see how the front running works for her. Stoyanova of Bulgaria will bring up the rear here. But Chang having a very close look at what's going on. And obviously, all these skaters know that it's just about qualification at this point, but we did see the Korean skaters yesterday, even in quarterfinals, they wanted to finish in first place, and this crowd here were urging them on to do so. There was no just settling for a top two finish or anything like that. They wanted to be winning and winning and winning, and Kamila Salmina has certainly made a strong start here, but guess what? Chung looks like she's ready to make a move, and Chung does indeed make a move, and the Latvian has just been overtaken there as Wozniak goes past her as well. And that's a big gap that opens up. The Polish skater just tracked Chung all the way. And I think unless there's a crash out, this one is done and dusted. And this one is going exactly according to plan. Cornelia Wozniak playing it very sensible here. She just watched and waited for Chung's attack. And when the Korean skater decided to go, she went with her. And that was that. So we're on the final lap, and Salmina and Stoyanova are completely blown off the ice. There's Chung and Wozniak end up, in the end, qualifying with a degree of comfort. Again, we got exactly what we expected. That's what the form guide suggested. Wozniak was very disappointed in her 1500 metres skating. She picked up plenty of medals at the recent European Youth Olympic Festival and was considered a dark horse. But I think we saw more of her potential there, the way she just sat behind Chung Jae-hee and secured a comfortable second place. But it's the perfect start for the host nation here, with Kang Min-ji winning heat number one, Chung Jae-hee winning heat number two. And it was pretty comfortable, wasn't it? Salmina of Latvia and Stoyanova of Bulgaria were considered the rank outsiders. Good to see the Latvian taking it on early, but once Chung hit the front, Wozniak just had to stay with her. And then it was a case of have a look and see what's happening in the rearview mirror. And to be honest with you, the other two skaters were so far away, they were out of sight, literally, these two. Comfortable as you like. Well, we will be seeing plenty from our referee, because if there's any kind of bumping and contact, this will have to be checked out. I must admit, I didn't see anything there, but we'll have to wait for the official confirmation. And if in doubt, check it out is always the motto. And I think we can read the body language there. Nothing to see here.
We have the result for heat number two, qualified to the final, Republic of Korea.
There it is, confirmed. Chung and Wozniak through to the quarterfinals. So let's move on to heat number three then. With the skaters out already, we just saw a look there at Sara Martinelli. But it's Angel Dalaman of the Netherlands and Kyung Yun Jang representing the United States are the favoured skaters here. Martinelli with Chan Xingying of Hong Kong, China, on the outside. Both Dalaman and Jang made the B final yesterday. Dalaman had all the bad luck that you could possibly have through that 1500 metres competition, and she gets off to a slow start here, the Dutch woman, but really should get through here, as should the soul-born Kang. She's talked about how thrilled she is to come back to the country of her birth, but representing the United States. It's Martinelli who's decided to set the pace, and Chang of Hong Kong, China, has already been cut adrift. So we're looking for two from three here, and the big question is, can Martinelli hold a top two spot? She's taking Jang along with her. Dalaman has just sat behind them. The Dutch skater who came in with an absolute Fort Knox level gold medal collection from the recent Junior World Championships. Was very, very disappointed. Even the B race for it, she crashed out and ended up finishing last. I mean, all the bad luck that she could have, she'll hope she's used up. She's tucked into third place. I wouldn't be at all surprised to see an attack from her, because she looks very strong and comfortable. And Martinelli has been passed by Jang already here. The Italian skater will be aware that she's got Dalaman right behind her. And there goes Dalaman, taking it around the outside, taking it into first place, just biding her time. And now the question, as Dalaman just races clear here, is whether Martinelli can overhaul the American skater Jang Kyung Yun. But Dalaman has decided no dramas and no mishaps this time. And there's no second place for Martinelli. Jang paced it perfectly, and that's something we didn't see yesterday. Angel Dalaman all smiles. A genuine medal prospect who is competing in the two disciplines, just the regular speed skating as well as the short track. She's got a very, very busy games ahead of her, and she's a genuine medal contender every time she's on the ice. Well, we didn't see it yesterday in the 1500 metres, but we saw it here in, admittedly, just a heat. She just sat back there, and when she decided to go, nobody could stay with her. Just gliding by The American skater there around that bend, effortless and smooth. And once she hit the front, there was no stopping it. And Jiang playing it safe, securing second place. Nothing for the referee to consider here. An easy one too. Dalaman and Kyung through to the quarterfinals. Now our next heat, on paper, looks wide open. It's Kazakhstan, Italy, Slovenia and Latvia. Anastasia Astrankantseva of Kazakhstan qualified for the B final yesterday. Sara Mirazzi of Italy, Dina Span of Slovenia and Madara Gintera of Latvia failed to progress to the final stages. So there's no one standout skater here. Although the form guide from yesterday, make of that what you will, would suggest that Astrakantseva may be the favoured athlete here, but we'll wait and see. But all four of these skaters will have come to the start line thinking, I can win this one, I can get second place, I can qualify. And at the moment, it's Gintera front running with Span tucked in just behind her. Astrakantseva in third place and Mirazzi sitting at the back. Always worth watching the skater at the back because it's usually one of two things. They're either just outclassed and they're stuck there, or they're sitting there biding their time waiting to attack. And I don't think Mirazzi looks outclassed. She looks pretty comfortable there at the moment. And all four of them staying in that grouping. And now it's the Slovenian Span that decides to go, and she attacks, and attacks very strongly, followed by Astrakantseva. Mirazzi moves up into third place as Gintera is cut loose with four laps to go. So this is just two into three now. And Mirazzi's still got some work to do, and it's the Slovenian Span that has been overhauled now by Astrakantseva. And Mirazzi is closing in on the Slovenian as well. But, yep, Astrakantseva has attacked and has left everybody standing. And Mirazzi has got past Span. And I think that might be our 1-2 right here. Astrakantseva has taken a lot of meters out of the rest of the field here. And Mirazzi has gone past and left Span standing. And again, no dramas. Astrakantseva was the favoured skater. She's come through. And Sara Mirazzi sat at the back, knowing second place would be good enough. And it'll be her that will be joining Astrakantseva in the quarterfinals. Dina Span tried to work it out from the front, but got overhauled. Dana Gintera of Latvia, the early leader. But when they pressed the go button, she was left. And then pressing the go button around that bend was Anastasia Astrakantseva. And once she was gone, that was it. It was always just then who could finish second. And Sara Mirazzi securing that spot. And that's heat number four, just like that. Confirmation then. Kazakhstan and Italy through to the quarterfinals. This is another strong heat as well with Nonomi Inoue of Japan, the bronze medalist from the 1500 metres. On the inside of Courtney Charlong of Canada, Mikhaila Isarova of Slovakia and Diana Demochko of Ukraine. Inoue, of course, a medalist yesterday, will be the overwhelming favourite here. Charlong from Campbellton, New Brunswick, will be hoping to join her in the top two. That's if it goes according to the script, of course. Because Isarova and Demochko have their own plans. And it's the Slovakian who is leading from the front. Oh, and we've lost Demochko already. Just lost it round that bend. That's a mental mistake. That's tough for her. So we're down to three here. And the big question is, can Mikaela Isarova stay in the lead here? It doesn't look like it, because Xiaolong's decided now's the time to go, and Inoue has barely worked up a sweat here. The Japanese skater gliding effortlessly into second place, and I think it's going to take something very, very special from Mikaela Isarova to break that partnership. She's staying close. She is not out of this yet. As we get down inside four laps to go, Xiaolong looking comfortable, and Inoue sitting there in second place, and the gap has opened up, and I don't think that gap is going to get closed down. So we've got another one that's going to the script here. The only question is, how much effort does Inoue want to put in? Does she want to win it, or is she happy just to sit there and take second? And he's found the inside lane, just attacked on the inside. Xiaolong will, I think, just sit there and say, okay, absolutely no sense in risking anything from here, and that's the 1-2 we expected. Isarova will take third place, and spare a thought for poor Diana Demochko, who crashed out. But the bronze medalist from the 1500 metres safely through. Isarova's time is not going to be one of the two fastest third placers. They're currently Sara Martinelli and Birgit Rath from the first heat. As we get ready for heat number six, and that's one of those moments you dread. Don't think there's even anything for the referee to review there. Demochko just lost it around that bend. Just a little mental lapse in concentration, that's all it took. And Inoue decided, I don't want to come second. And Courtney Xiaolong said, well, I don't mind coming second. And that was that. Yep, nothing for the referee to consider. And it's Japan and Canada safely through. No drama yet in these heats. As our next heat, heat number six, will be an all-European affair. Dora Shigeti, who was in tears at the end of the 1500 metres, run out of it and ending up in fourth place. We'll be joined by Anna Falkowska, who looked good until she crashed out round a bend. They'll be the two favoured skaters, with Eva Vlahova of the Czech Republic and Veronika Kramer of Ukraine rounding out our quartet on the ice.
Go to the start. Ready.
So away we go then with heat number six. And never a good idea to front run, as we've seen already from the heats, but Eva Vlahova has decided that's exactly what she's going to do, and it's Veronika Kramer who's struggling a little bit already, the Ukrainian, with a bit of ground to make up here. And Shigeti and Falkowska just having a little look at what Vlahova is up to here. I think the Polish skater is interesting, because she looks so comfortable and then just crashed out under no pressure at all. You could see the potential that she had. Shigeti, with that fourth place finish, will certainly be one of the medal contenders in this competition as well. But at the moment, Eva Vlahova is not burning up too much energy, but the other two are in their slipstream, and Kramer remains in contact here, having allowed a little gap to open up, but then she's closed that down. So she's still very much engaged here as well. But who's going to make a move, and when are they going to make it? That's the question. Vlahova is hoping nobody makes a move. Left a lot of gap on the inside there, though, and two of them, Shigeti and Valkovska, said, oh, you just opened the door. We'll walk right through it. Thank you very much. So it's the 1-2 we're expecting. Shigeti looking very, very comfortable, and that's Valkovska deciding, I'm going to hit the front. Little gap opens up. Vlahova's struggling to keep up. And the front two still in cruise control. Falkowska taking Shigeti with her. And that's the end of that. Again, not a fast time. So I don't think we'll be seeing Ava Blahova in the quarterfinal, because her time is not going to be good enough for one of the two fastest third-place finishers. But Anna Falkowska, really good to see that from her, because that'll just restore her confidence after that crash out in the 1,500 metres. And Shigeti, though, I mean, that was a training exercise for her, as it has been indeed for most of the qualifiers here. But no point burning up any energy in the heats. There's the competition's going to get a lot tougher, and it's a long and difficult route through to the final. With the heats, it's just a question of navigating them with a minimum of fuss, and that's what Anna Falkowska and Dora Shigeti of Poland and Hungary have done. Still three heats to go. And we'll see a very interesting one here, because there's the three European skaters. There's not an awful lot between them on paper. Paula Torshevsky, we saw in the B final yesterday. And Diana Vagy, we saw her in the final in the 1,500 metres as well. And Lea Popovikova of Slovakia only just missed out on that B final. Amelia Chua of Singapore is the fourth skater. You'd fancy Vagy and Torshevsky to come out of this group, as we just get some repairs affected here. But Popovikova of Slovakia is a very live contender, and this should be, looks on paper, a fascinating battle between the three Europeans. And Amelia Chua of Singapore is no doubt saying, hey, what about me? Like any sport, you never overlook anybody. But it's Torshevsky of Germany on the inside. Vagy of Hungary next to her. Popovikova of Slovakia and Chua of Singapore on the left as we look. This is heat number 7 of 9. And Torshevsky is happy to let it all unfold in front of her as Popovikova decides to be the front runner here, with Vagy tracking her. Popovikova's gone off fast. Now, this might be smart, because if this is a bit of a three-way shootout, she knows with only two heats to go exactly what she needs to get a very fast time and the possibility of advancing with a third-place finish. That's if she does get run out of it. So Popovikova playing this very sensible. Chua still there, comfortably in touch as well. Vagy sitting in second place, and Torshevsky has made no kind of move at all. And the pace has dropped a little bit. I think Popovikova might want to just be picking this up as we get down with five laps to go, because the skaters behind her are very comfortable. So she's doing all the hard work. And as you can see with the arms behind the back there, they're just slipstreaming. Now there's a move coming from Vagy, who's decided to make a bit of a move, and the pace picks up again. Vagy does make that move. Popovikova manages to hold off Torshevsky here around that bend. But the German is now starting to build up some momentum as well here. Vagy is away and clear. Torshevsky has moved into second place. And what kind of legs does Lea Popovikova have left? Because she's been badly cut adrift here. And I think all that work she's put in early, she's blown up pretty badly. And it's going to be a question of what her time is. Vagy and Torshevsky, they know it's job done. See you in the quarterfinals. And that's a fast time from Lea Popovikova. She's got a real chance with only two heats to come. But no clock watching for Diana Vagy and Paula Torshevsky. They know they're through. I think she did the right thing here, Lea Popovikova, because it is all about a chance are getting a fastest third place finish opportunity, and knowing what's happened up to now, you can throw that down and say, well, I've given myself a chance here. And the time, we'll wait for the official confirmation, that will at the moment put her as the fastest of our third place finishers with only two to go. Yeah, 137.9, that is good enough. And I think that will relegate our third place finisher from Heat 1, Birgit Rat of the Netherlands. She'll be out of it. And sitting on the hot seat now is Sara Martinelli as our second fastest third place finisher with two to go. And this is... there's only three in this heat, but this is a tough heat. This is a tough heat. Li Jinzi of the People's Republic of China, silver medalist in the 1500 metres, goes against Océane Girard of Canada with Paulina Omelchuk, who was a finalist in the 1500 metres and skated brilliantly to get to that final for Kazakhstan on the outside. So only three skaters, but check out the quality. You'd have to say Girard, the Canadian, is probably the underdog of these three. That's how strong a heat this is. Li, the Chinese skater, would just sit at the back and say, you guys do your thing. I'll attack any time I like. Omelchuk, who had such a super skate in the 1500 metres, sitting in second place. And Océane Girard, who does all her work at the National Training Centre in Montreal, part of that next-gen group of Canadian speed skaters, leading the way here. And no move at all from Li Jinzi. But you just know that she can attack at any time. And you know the attack's coming. It's whether Omelchuk can overhaul Girard that will be the interesting question here. Still the Canadian leads, and the Canadian has decided, let's keep it fast. And that's smart, because there's every chance she will end up in third place here, but a fast time could be enough to see her through to the quarterfinals, and she's skating really well with three laps to go. Li just sitting there waiting to move. Omelchuk has decided it's time for me to make my move, and she hits the front, and Li will move into second place. And the only question is whether Li decides she wants to hit the front, and she does. And Omelchuk has just taken there around that bend. So Li Jinzi just bides her time. Omelchuk will take second place. And that's got a chance for Paulina Omelchuk. We will have to wait for the official time, but she's got every chance. And that's smart from her. Went off fast, set the quick pace. Was always the underdog in that group of three when you're going up against two of the finalists from the 1500 metres. So her best chance was to set a fast time. And I think the young Canadian has had a very, very smart heat here. But Li with a minimum of effort, and Omelchuk are the two that will advance as of right to our quarterfinal. And that's exactly what we expected. And Girard has the fastest third place time with only one heat to go. So every expectation that we will see the Canadian in the quarterfinals. On the hot seat and sweating now is the Slovakian, who we just saw a couple of heats ago, Lea Popovicova. She is our current second fastest third place skater as we get down to heat number nine, the final heat, which features Aoi Yoshizawa of Japan, Yang Jingru of the People's Republic of China, the gold medalist from the 1500 metres. They will be the overwhelming favourites. Maiwen Longavin of France and Valentina Levikita of Lithuania. We'll be hoping they're doing a bit more than just making up the numbers. Yoshizawa of Japan reached the B final. in the 1500 meters, but Yang, who had that stunning skate. If you get a chance to watch the 1500 meter final, go and find it, because what she did was quite extraordinary. She's at the back, and if she doesn't win this heat, it will be a big story. Yoshizawa leading the way, and it's the two Europeans, Longovat and Levikita of Lithuania. We're just hoping that something happens that might open the door for them. But at the moment, Yang just sitting back and watching as Yoshizawa continues to lead. But just keep your eye right at the back, because she'll go, and when she goes, good luck stopping her. Little move around that bend into third and then down the back straight. There she goes, around the bend. I tell you, that's a strong skate, though, from Yoshizawa, but she can't hold her off. But this is blown open now. Longevant in third place has just got to put on the afterburners here and hope she can get a fast time, because it's going to be the two finalists from the 1500 metres that will advance out of this particular heat, as expected. And Yang and Yoshizawa have just slowed it all down. They're not bothered, and I don't think that is going to be a fast enough third place finish for Maywen Longevin, which could be good news. We'll await official confirmation, as Ocean Gera and Lea Popovikova of Slovakia may have earned themselves a chance at joining the skaters in the quarterfinals as our two fastest third place finishers. But we expected this to be comfortable for the 1500 metre medalist, gold medalist, of course. And she did what she had to do, joined by Yoshizawa of Japan. Well, I did promise at the start of the day there'll be lots of drama and lots of thrills and spills. After the heats have concluded, no drama at all. Every single one of these heats for the women's 1,000 metre short track speed skating competition going exactly according to the script. Next stop for our women skaters, the quarterfinals. Next stop for us, as we just take a look at the confirmed group, and it's Ocean Guerra of Canada, who does indeed take one of those third place berths. And indeed, Lea Popovikova of Slovakia, good enough. Now those two went off fast, and they've earned their reward. So, next stop, the quarterfinals for the women. Next stop for us, it's the heats for the men. And they'll be coming straight out here as well. Well, there's the skater to keep an eye on in this first heat, Daniele Zampedri, who won the B final. Rather surprised everybody picking up that award. Victor Chartron of Canada will also be favoured. There's Christoph Madry of Poland and David Kestielyi of Hungary. Rounding out the quartet in this first heat for the men's 1,000 metres. On the inside, it's Chartron, who decides, I'll take it from here, thank you very much. And Zampedri will stay with him, and a little bit of a move around the backside there. We'll see Kestielyi take a short-lived lead, and then Chartron decides, my turn. Oh, we're getting lots of jostling and movement going on here at the moment with Chartron. Gonna stay out of trouble. Oh, and there's a bump. And two have gone. Oh, that's so unlucky there for Madry and Kestielyi. They've hit the floor, which means that the two favoured skaters, Daniele Zampedri and Victor Chartron, can just glide through the rest of this heat. The other two have to pick themselves up and hope that something happens here, but this is just a little practice session now for the Canadian and the Italian. So unfortunate then for the two that crashed out, Madri and Castelli. Nothing they can do now except hope that one of these two makes a major and unexpected mistake. It's a real free hit for these two, just a chance to get a good feel, a good competitive feel of this ice. Nothing's wasted, of course. And that's exactly how they're playing it. Pick the tempo up, but Zampedri in second place, very, very happy just to sit there and go along and work right alongside Victor Chartrand, who will take first place. And the two of them thinking, hey, how easy was that? Well, we got the luck there. Well, they were the favoured too, but that was rather more comfortable than I suppose either of them were expecting. Got to feel sorry for Madri and Castelli crashing out like that. But that comes with the turf here, doesn't it? Well, that's Castelli leading them around. And there he is on the inside, and it's he that loses out and takes Madri with him. Just clips his skate. The Polish skater, very, very unlucky. Almost got around there, didn't he? And yeah, that's all it takes. And it could have been one of those two. That's the luck of this sport. You need the brakes to go your way. And for Chartrand and Zampedri, the brakes went perfectly for them. And it was a tough break for Madri and Castelli. And we won't be seeing them in the quarterfinals. The referee, of course, will have to have a look at it, as there's always an official adjudication needed whenever there's contact. But in this situation, it's completely academic. There's one more look. Well, it's certainly Castelli's fault. He's the one that loses it. Very, very unlucky. He's almost got through there, Madri, but almost not enough. They will let Madri advance, though, which is what the official was looking at. So we will see him in the quarterfinals, as no blame attaches to him at all for the crash out. So he'll be thinking all's well that ends well, as we look at Peter Grossclose here of the Philippines, born and raised in California, but representing the nation of his parents. Mohamed Bozdag of Turkey, a finalist in the 1500 metres. Moritz Hartmann and Nicholas Toskov of Germany and Bulgaria, respectively, rounding out our quartet here. Bozdag will be the favoured athlete. Grossclose, who failed to reach either the A or B final, will be hoping for better fortune in the 1000 than we saw in the 1500. And deciding the front run is Moritz Hartmann of Germany, who also had a crash out and never really got going in the 1500 metres. Well, maybe the 1000 metres is more to his liking, because he's decided to set the hot pace here, with Toskov struggling at the back. And now Bozdag, who qualified for the final of the 1500 metres, came last in that final. Such a high-class final. He decides he's going to hit the front, and Grossclose is going to stay with him. And now the question is, can Hartmann stay close and make it interesting? Could we have a photo finish here? It's all been plain sailing so far in these heats. No real dramas, but Hartmann is trying to stay with them, but the gap's opened up with three laps to go, and you don't want to see a gap like that. He's got to close that down right here. comfortable is Bozdag. And Grossclose decides he wants to be even more comfortable. He'll hit the front. Bozdag will just be aware of where Hartmann is. And we're on the final lap, and I don't think the German can close this gap down. No, it's getting wider. So it's Peter Grossclose representing the Philippines. And Mohamed Bozdag of Turkey, who will advance to the quarterfinals. Yeah, that's more like it, is what Grossclose is thinking. Didn't see him at his best in the 1500 metres. That's an indication there of his potential. So he will fly the flag of the Philippines into the quarterfinals. Only the third ever Filipino athlete in this competition. And there's a huge sense of pride for him in representing the Philippines. And Bozdag, no fuss. In the heats, it's all about getting the job done. Nicholas Toskov of Bulgaria got cut loose early. Just couldn't keep up. And so it's Grossclose and Bozdag who will advance. So the skaters for heat number three are on the ice. And this one features Brazil, United States, Netherlands and France. Lucas Ku, Julius Kazanecki, Nick Endeveld and Timeo Libeau. Kazanecki reached the B final of the 1500 metres. Lucas Ku showed potential that he could get there as well, only to crash out. They'll be the two favoured skaters here, Endeveld of the Netherlands and Libeau of France. The two skaters hoping to have something to say about that. And Koop decides he wants to hit the front early. Kazanecki from Bethesda, Maryland, takes second place, with the Dutch and French skaters bringing up the rear. We've often seen skaters at the back just looking and watching and then making a move and attacking. And let's see if one of these two has got something up his sleeve here, as Koop looks happy front running. Kazanecki's just having a look around and seeing what's there, and there is an attack coming through, and we've seen another crash out, and the two Europeans are gone. I tell you, Kazanecki had a bump there as well, but managed to stay upright. So, once again, in the men's heats of the 1,000 metres, a bit more drama. Libeau and Endeveld have picked themselves up, but I think there's a chance that one of them might be advanced to the quarterfinals on the no-blame bump. But what we are seeing here is Lucas Ku and Julius Kazanecki getting a free hit, free ride. With two laps to go, Kazanecki's decided why waste any effort at all, and who can blame him? Ku's decided, well, let me see if I can pick up speed here. What can I do coming off these bends, coming around the bends? Looking at quarterfinals and beyond, he is. Takes it comfortably. Kazanecki says, don't care about my time. Second place finish will do me. And Endeveld and Libeau. Very, very disappointing for the two Europeans. Yeah, the Brazilian fans in the crowd, very, very happy that Lucas Ku will be seen in the quarterfinals. That's Endeveld in third place. And lots of bump in there. Yeah. Libeau might get the free ride here if there's no blame attached to him. Kazanecki, there was some contact there as well, which is what brought Endeveld down. So the referee is going to have some adjudicating to do in this heat. Sometimes it's just a quick look, but I think this is going to need a much longer look here a question mark potentially over Kazaneki's involvement. A question mark of whether Timeo Libo was involved in any way, and if he wasn't, does he get the advance? Lots of decisions for the referee here. So this one won't be rushed through. So many of the decisions are pretty simple. You only need one quick look just to confirm what you think you've already seen, but this one is a bit more complicated than that. Take a look at Kazaneki. As Endeavour looks to try and work his way through there, and that's the contact that starts it all. And Libo then gets caught up in it as well, and he hits the deck, having tangled up with Endeveld. Ku's fine, no problem with him, and it's Libo actually who gets caught by Kazaneki in the first place, not Endeveld. That's my mistake, excuse me for that. Now the Dutchman might be saying, well, hey, there's an argument that I get advanced here. This is going to be interesting. Well, the decision has been made, and we will see what that decision is. And here it is. Yeah, it's Libo that does advance, and it's Kazaneki that is penalised. Endeveld will qualify, having skated into a third place. And the no blame for Libo means he advances, and a big surprise here as Julius Kazaneki is penalised. Well, it was his initial contact, and the referee had a really good long look at it. Right, Heat 4 features Sean Shuai of the United States, Jonas de Jong of the Netherlands, Zhang Jinye of the People's Republic of China, and Aditya Nguyen of Australia, of the Ruse Club in Brisbane, Australia. Strong-looking group here, and the Aussie hits the deck straight away. Well, he was always going to be the outsider of this quartet, Zhang of the People's Republic of China, silver medalist in the 1500 metres. Shuai, a fourth place finisher in the 1500 metres. The only real question is, can Jonas de Jong get in among those two who will be not only red hot favourites here in this heat, but also amongst the favourites to medal in this competition? It's a horrible, horrible draw for de Jong and Nguyen. They look like they're here to make up the numbers. Well, the Aussie has picked himself up and done well. He stays in touch, but you know that Zhang can just turn on the jets anytime he wants, and Shuai, you know, can go with him, and there we go, just like that. Shuai decides he wants to hit the front. Zhang's going to let him. Gutsy this from De Jong. He's attacked on the inside, but then is immediately has it taken back off him by Zhang. But De Jong staying with these two, and there's a chance the Dutchman's going to get a quick time here, even if he does have to settle for third place, because he's there with him. This is smart from De Jong. But it's Zhang leading Shuai. And now De Jong is finding the going a little bit hot. Got to try and push round, try and stay with it as we get onto the final lap. But no, this one, again, the cream is rising to the top. Two finalists from the 1500 metres have qualified for the quarterfinals of the 1,000 metres, as expected. Well, I'm sure Jonas de Jong and Aditya Nguyen, when they saw the draw for the heats, must have groaned, because you've got two of them. Maybe that's exactly what he was thinking right there. Why put me in this group? Because not only have you got the 1500 metre silver medalist, but you've got the fourth place finisher in that event as well. In your heat. What an awful draw for the other two. It was always going to be the longest of long shots. De Jong tried to stay with him, And he'll have to wait and see if his time is going to be fast enough. But he faded so badly, I don't think that is going to be good enough. So there's heat number four into the record books. This one, heat five, should be a good one as well. As this one's quite evenly matched. It's got Dominic Mayor, who reached the B final in the 1500 metres. Toprak Erolu, another B finalist from the 1500 metres. Hasan Gurov of Bulgaria and Loie Dekkens of Belgium, who just failed to qualify for the B final in the 1500 metres. So no guaranteed standout here. Although Mayor and Erolu will be the two favoured skaters, but Dekkens on the outside there is definitely a live contender here. And Gurov, we've got a steady start here. Very, very steady. Gurov just stood up and said, I don't want to be the leadoff guy. So Dekkens, the Belgian, will take it. As I say, in the 1500 metres, the Belgian was a whisker away from reaching that B final. So he's got a genuine chance of a top two finish here if Erolu or Mayor underestimate him. They're currently in third and fourth, respectively, as Gurov, the Bulgarian, sits in second place. It's slow so far, and the big injection of pace comes in, and they all got a little bit close there as Erolu decided it's time to attack, and Erolu has done just that. Gurov stays with him in second place. Dekkens drops back to third, and Mayor is the tail-end Charlie here. But not for much longer, I suspect, as we get down to four laps to go. It's Dekkens now who finds himself at the back as Mayor moves up from fourth to second behind Erolu. And the Hungarian decides, well, I want to hit the front now. And he's taking Erolu around with him. And it's Dekkens that's dropped right out of this one. Gurov still skating well, the Bulgarian in third place. Having a really strong skate here to make it interesting. And he's attacked and got past Erolu. Oh, this is going to be interesting. Now then, Erolu's in trouble. He's lost it completely. No problems for Mayor. And Hasan Gurov, with a super skate, will take second place. What happened to Toprak Erolu? Seemed to just run out of gas on that final lap. Loie Dekkens, having been a front runner, he too found the going way too hot to handle. Dominic Mayor, very, very comfortable in the end. And Hasan Gurov was really smart, always kept himself very much in contact with whoever was in front. And I must admit, I thought when Erolu went past him and relegated him to third place, that was going to be it. That was the top two done right there, as they were away and clear. I think Gurov came straight back at him. And once he went past him, it was Erolu who suddenly found the gas tank hit empty and had no response. So Mayor through, and he'll be joined by Gurov, the Bulgarian. And Erolu, there was a bit of a bump in there, which is why this is going to be looked at. I would think this is going to be a brief one, but you never know. But let's wait for that confirmation from the referee rather than from me. What do I know? But usually those hand gestures mean forget about it. So here we are then. Yeah. Nothing to see here. Tell you, 139. That's not getting you through this phase. That's a real surprise. Well, you heard the ripple of applause. That's because Kim Yo-sung of the Republic of Korea is going to be seen in this heat. He was the bronze medalist from the 1500 metres. And Mirjan Toligan of Kazakhstan, Freddy Polak from Great Britain, and good to see Luka Jasic of Serbia, who crashed out in the 1500 metres and was taken off the ice on a stretcher. Thank goodness for him that his games were not over. He'll be hoping for less drama here. Jasic was a silver in the European Youth Olympic Festival. In the shorter distance, the 500 metres, and was competing in the World Junior World Championships in 2024. He's a very, very classy skater. But Kim will expect to win this heat very, very comfortably. The big question is whether Polak is able to get any kind of attack on Luka Jasic, and how fully healthy is the Serbian? Looks okay, doesn't he? The Kazakhstan skater, Merijan Toligin, decides he wants to attack. He crashed out in the 1500s. And he's taking a very strange line. Went inside, then went outside. Kim has decided, you know what, I don't want any fuss here. And he's taken Jasic with him. Polak is still in touch as well. And Toligin hasn't given this one up either. It's a very, very decent little heat, this, because they're all in it with three laps to go. And there's the Kazakhstani getting inside, and that's pretty much done it for Polak. He's lost a lot of ground there off that attack from Toligin. But it's Kim and Jasic that are away and clear. Polak has managed to get past back into third place. He's got to keep the pressure on this final lap to try and secure a fast time. But he's not going to catch the top two as Kim takes Jasic around. And they will be the qualifiers, and Polak will have to wait and see if he's come up with a fast enough time to advance. Well, there was a little bump there between Toligin and Polak. Well, the referee, I'm sure, will just have a quick check. But I'm not sure there's much of a discussion to be had with the video guys. Really good as well to see Luka Jasic. You hate to see an athlete, especially a young athlete, on such a stage as this, have to bow out with an injury. He's okay, and we'll see him again in the quarterfinals. Polak, with a time of 1:32. Is hanging on to a spot here by his fingertips, with still three heats to go. Heat number seven will feature Zhang Bohao of the People's Republic of China and Raito Kida of Japan. They were both finalists in the 1500 meters. Aaron Pietro Bono of Italy and Yerasil Shingiskan making up the numbers here on paper.
Go to start.
Right. It's another one of those heats, isn't it, where if you're one of the European skaters, you're looking and going, oh, not one, but two top skaters who've already reached the 1500 meters final, and who will be favourite here? Ju Jae-hee, the gold medalist in the 1500 meters for Korea, leading them round, with Raito Kida of Japan expected to join him, unless Aaron Pietro Bono of Italy, who's the current front runner, or Yerasil Shingiskan of Kazakhstan can do something about it. But Ju Jae-hee, just very, very comfortable at the moment, as you'd expect. Kida will just try and sit there with him. And for Pietro Bono, it's a case of trying to hang on in here. And Shingiskan likewise, the tall Kazakhstan skater, trying to come through on the inside. And a lot of pushing and bumping going on behind the leading two. Shingiskan has pretty much lost too much ground there down that back straight. But he's out of it. Ju Jae-hee, or rather, excuse me, Zhang Bohao of China. It's due in the next heat. Getting ahead of myself. It's Zhang, the silver medalist, leading Raito Kida of Japan, the People's Republic of China in first, Japan in second. And that is the end of that. A comfortable as you like. Zhang, silver medalist from the 1500 meters, led from the front, and Kida of Japan followed him. And we'll be seeing them in the quarterfinals. Now, there was a bit of a bump between the Italian and the Kazakhstan at some point in the middle of this heat. But nothing was bothering the two Asian skaters. Zhang and Kida were away and clear once they'd decided to put Pietro Bono back in his place. The Italian briefly threatening to mix it up with them, but no way he could stay that pace. So it's the 1500 silver medalist Zhang Bohao of the People's Republic of China who takes first place. Reito Kida of Japan will be joining him in the quarterfinals as we get now to the gold medalist from the 1500 meters, Ju Jae-hee of Korea. And he is joined as we just get confirmation of the Zhang Kida 1-2 from heat number 7. Heat number 8 will feature Ju Jae-hee of Korea, the 1500 meter gold medalist. Rio Ong of Singapore, who was a surprise B finalist, will be alongside him. Frank Tecam of France and Vladimir Melnik of Ukraine are in positions 3 and 4. Heat 8 underway then, just one more after this, and it should be a routine stroll around the ice here for Ju Jae-hee in this 1,000-meter heat. Gold in the 1,500 meters, and he can lead from the front if he wants. He can sit at the back and attack if he wants. Everybody else is skating for second place, and they know it. It's Tecam, the Frenchman, who is currently in second place. Ong of Singapore with Melnik of Ukraine bringing up the rear here. But Ju just taking it nice and steady. I think if anybody does have the temerity to attack him, he'll put them straight back in their place. And at the moment, nobody is making any kind of attack at all. Melnik, the Ukrainian, has decided to take closer order, but trying to attack around the bend is always tough, and he hasn't been able to do anything. And Ju Jae-hee has just decided, yeah, let's just put a bit of a gap between myself and the rest of these guys. Let them battle it out for second. Tecam of France has been in that second spot pretty much from that opening bend, and he still stays there. Ong's got some work to do to try and close him down as we're inside the final two laps. It's the battle for second that's interesting here. And it's a really live battle as well. Tecam is still holding him off, but Ong is trying to make a move, and Melnik's trying to get through as well. Can Tecam hang on here? And yes, he can. It's a really good skate from Frank Tecam. Ju Jae-hee, yeah, of course he's going to be winning it. And of course he's going to be winning it as comfortably as you like. That was expected. That wasn't the drama in that heat. The battle for second place was what it was all about. Not that too many of these fans were looking at that. They are looking at the possibility of a double gold medalist at the very least from this event in Ju Jae-hee, 1500 meters gold, and safely through in his heat in the 1000 meters. And it's going to take a very special skater indeed to stop him. But keep an eye on Frank Tecam, who was very, very smart, just kept Ju Jae-hee in his sights, held second place from the very first bend right through to the finish line. That was a strong skate for him in not a fast time either. But he doesn't need a time if he's finished second. He's through. And Rio Ong of Singapore, a B finalist in the 1500 meters, his 1000 meters race is run. Melnik in fourth. So we come down to the final heat, heat 9 of the men's 1,000 meters short track speed skating, which features Yuta Fuchigama of Japan, Chon Lachat Taprom of Thailand, Villa Murray from Great Britain, and Alexis Dubuc-Bilodeau, the youngster from Canada, from Trois-Rivières, the 15-year-old on the outside, had a crash out in the 1500 metres, so he'll be looking to make up for that. That's a decent looking heat, this one as well. They'll all look at this and think, I got a chance. This should be a very, very competitive heat. And as the last group, they should also go flat out as well in the hope that a third place finish might be enough. And it's Willem Murray of Great Britain, the flag bearer at the opening ceremony for Great Britain from Nottingham, who leads the way, but pressure coming on the inside and the outside as Dubuc-Bilodeau attacks on the inside and he goes past him, and Fujigama attacks as well. And he hits the front. So Murray drops down to third place. It's Taprom of Thailand who's still there, but he's got some work to do. And that's a very nice bend taken by Murray there to get past Dubuc-Bilodeau. That's going to be a little ding-dong all the way to the finishing line. Fujigama has opened up a little bit of a gap here. And it looks like he's going to take Murray with him, unless Dubuc-Bilodeau has got a strong finish as we get down to two laps to go. Taprom, the Thai, is out of this. But there's three of them still very much alive as we get down to the final lap here. This could be a photo finish, because here comes Dubuc-Bilodeau on the inside and Murray holds him off. And Murray will take second place. Oh. Well, I think we can safely say, in terms of the heats, we saved the best till last. Fujigama was front running and was never challenged, but as you can see, he had to work to hold first place, because Murray and Dubuc-Bilodeau behind him were pushing him all the way. And that battle for second was absolutely gripping as well. It's Murray who will hold him off to secure a guaranteed place in the quarterfinal. As Dubuc-Bilodeau, the youngster, briefly there, threatened to secure second spot, but Murray managed to power his way past him and then hold him off as well. But it was a terrific skate from the Canadian. But is that going to be enough to get him into the quarterfinals as one of the two fastest third-place finishers? Every chance. That's fast. Every chance. Fujigama and Murray, they're safely through. And that's the heats done.
With all the online heats of the men's 1,000 meter complete.
So here we go. Libo of France, the no-blame crash-out victim. He is advanced to the quarterfinals. The ice will be dressed ahead of the quarterfinals. Christophe Madry also advanced for being the victim of a crash out as well. So we will see the pole in the quarterfinals as well. So the ice will be dressed then ahead of the women's quarterfinals.
Thank you to all the spectators who joined us at the stadium despite the cold weather. We would like to remind spectators to be safe as the floor can be slippery. If a visitor has an emergency or needs assistance, we ask that they contact the staff immediately for assistance.
추운 날 속에서도 경기장을 찾으신 여러분께 감사 인사를 전합니다. 바닥이 미끄러울 수도 있으니 입장하시는 관중 여러분께서는 안전에 신경 써주시길 바라겠습니다. 만약 응급 상황이 발생하거나 도움이 필요한 관람객께서는 즉시 안내 요원에게 도움을 요청해 주시면 감사하겠습니다. 경기 중에는 휴대전화의 벨소리와 카메라의 플래시도 꺼주시길 바라겠습니다. 최상의 관중 매너가 최상의 경기력을 만든다는 것 잊지 말아주시고 선수들에게 아낌없는 박수도 부탁드리겠습니다. 관람객분께서는 소지품 관리에 주의를 기울여주시고 분실물을 습득하셨다면 가까운 안내 요원에게 맡겨주시길 바라겠습니다.
women's 1,000-meter quarterfinals will begin in just a few moments.
잠시 후 여자 1,000m 준준결승전이 시작되겠습니다.
Again, 20 players are divided into four groups of five skaters each. The first and second place finishers in each group will qualify to the semifinals, and up to two of the top three finishers in each group will qualify to the semifinals. Don't be discouraged if you're in third place. You can still make it to the semifinals if you play your best. Let's start with the group number one, brick matches.
20명의 선수가 5명씩 4개 조로 나뉘어서 경기가 진행됩니다. 경기 결과 각조 1, 2위 선수가 준결승전에 진출.
Semi-final time then, or quarter-final time, excuse me, for the women's 1,000-meter skaters. 20 have made it through the heats. And we will be seeing four quarter-finals with five in each group. And it is a high-class field, from which only the top two in each quarterfinal will advance, along with the two fastest third-place finishers. Some very good skaters will be leaving the competition right here, because the strength in depth is really strong. And that is highlighted in our very first quarterfinal, which features three of the seven finalists from the 1,500 metres. Including the bronze medalist Nonomi Inoue of Japan. She will be joined by Polina Omolchuk of Kazakhstan, who finished sixth, and from the host nation, the Republic of Korea, Chung Jae-hee, who crashed out in that final. And they'll be joined by Ocean Gierard of Canada and Cornelia Wozniak of Poland, who are both very capable skaters in their own right. This is a strong group. All eyes will be on Chung Jae-hee, who's drawn the fourth position, second left to us as we are looking. But pick your top two out of this, because this is a strong group. They're all strong groups. The first quarterfinal in the women's 1,000 metres then. And it's going to be Nonomi Inoue who decides to set the tone right from the start, and all five of these skaters know we can't be messing around here. This has got to be good, and it's got to be strong. Chung decides to lead, with Inoue following, and Omolchuk in third place. And it's Wozniak and Gerard bringing up the rear. All five skaters very much in contention here. Let's see if there's going to be any attacks or any moves, and when are those moves going to happen? Front running and not messing around here is Chung Jae-hee. She's just decided to set a hot pace and see who can stay with her. And so far, everybody is staying with her. As we get down to four laps to go, still no move from any of these skaters. Another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 unchanged. Now it looks like Omolchuk is going to attack on the inside. She can't get through, though. Inoue fights her off. And a little gap has opened up there. And whether they can close it down, Chung has just decided, hit the front and stay there after that crash out. She just wants no problems at all, and she looks like she's skating beautifully here. Omolchuk does get inside Inoue. Now that's a big move as well for her. And then it's Gerard who comes through. Wow! Whoa, what an attack that was! Just when it looked like Omolchuk had got the better of Inoue. I think Gerard came storming through, and that was all going on behind our winner, Chung Jae-hee, who just went out from the front and said, catch me if you can. And they couldn't. Well, there was no place for experimentation in a quarterfinal of that caliber. And Chung just decided, let's just go out there and make it happen. And that's exactly what she did. And the drama was going on that last lap when Ocean Gerard popped up out of nowhere. Just when it looked like Omelchuk had done the business getting past Inoue, there she is on the inside, making that big move. And that'll secure her second place on a semi-final berth. What a skate from Ocean Gerard. Polina Omelchuk down in third place. Cornelia Wozniak in fourth. And the bronze medalist from the 1500 meters, Naomi Inoue, in fifth place. I told you it was a strong group. Didn't realize it was that strong. And what a skate from Ocean Gerard to take second place. That's quarterfinal number one done. Catch your breath, because quarterfinal number two is coming up. Some strong contenders here, including Diana Vegi of Hungary, who just missed out on a podium place in the 1500-meter final. Paola Torshevsky and Kang Min-ji of the Republic of Korea were B-finalists. Eliza Rodhamel of the United States and Sara Marazzi of Italy are rounding out this group. And away we go. Quarterfinal number two then. And again, a real buzz as Kang Min-ji will look to secure herself a no-frills, no-fuss place in the semi-final. A lot of work to be done here, because the early pace is being set by Torshevsky, who's gone off really fast. And Vegi stays with her, and on the outside, there goes Kang with the big attack. Rodhamel is in fourth place, and Marazzi's finding this tough going in fifth, and it's Kang front running. Now, can anybody catch her? Torshevsky stays close. Vegi in third place at the moment. She does want to be staying there. And Rodhamel still very much in it as well. This is going to be a fascinating attack as well. There's going to be some kind of attack here, surely, on Kang. And it looks like Vegi has decided, right, time to make a move. And Vegi has indeed made that big move. And a big gap suddenly, just like that, opens up. But Kang is comfortable. Vegi looks very comfortable behind her, and they've broken the back of this group. Well, it's been a very strong state from Kang Min-ji, and Diana Vegi has just watched her very, very closely and has skated very cleverly to secure second place, with Paola Torshevsky of Germany holding off Eliza Rodhamel for third. But Kang, well, is following the blueprint here in these women's 1,000-meter quarterfinals. The coaching is clear. They were allowed to just sit at the back and coast through the heats. But the coaching staff obviously said hit the front and lead from the front in these quarterfinals. And that worked perfectly for Kang Min-ji. Diana Vegi was struggling to get past Paola Torshevsky for a while, but when she did, there was no response from the German, who in the end was hanging on to third place. And she'll have to wait and see if she's picked up a fast enough time to qualify as one of the third place finishers. But Kang and Vegi didn't bother attacking. She was happy just to sit in second place and advance to the semi-final. But another good one. And it's Kang and Vegi that qualify. Torshevsky will have to sit and wait, and her time a little bit slower than Polina Omelchuk from heat number one. So her hopes hang by a slender thread. We now get ready for quarterfinal number three. And a little look there at Courtney Charlong of Canada. Angel Dalaman also in this group with Yang Jingru, the gold medalist from the 1500 meters. Aoi Yoshizawa and Lea Popovikova of Slovakia, one of the fastest third-place skaters. We'll have to come up with something very special to come out of this group. Yang will be, of course, the overwhelming favourite. Dalament, the Dutch skater who underachieved in the 1500 metres, looks so much stronger in the heats here. They'll be the favoured too. But let's see what happens as Courtney Sharong of Canada and Ayu Yoshizawa of Japan and Lea Popovikova will hope to have something to say about this one. It should be a very, very high-class quarter-final, this one again. With Yang of China tucked in second place there behind Yoshizawa. Everybody else just taking a look. Dalament, the Dutch skater in third place, just tracking. Sharlong in fourth and Popovikova bringing up the rear here, but it's Yoshizawa who tries to head off an attack there from Dalament, and Dalament is still continuing to attack on the outside, and Yang has held her off to hold first place, but Angel Dalament has now moved into second ahead of Yoshizawa. Courtney Sharlong still with them for Canada. And it's Yang continuing the lead, and this is a nice attack from Sharlong on the inside. She sneaked through into third place here. It's Yoshizawa of Japan that's struggling a little bit here down in fourth place. This is a really strong, strong heat as we get down to the final lap, and it's Yang continuing to lead from Dalament. Sharlong in third place, and Yoshizawa's in a bit of trouble here. That's our 1-2-3. Yang holds off Dalament, who holds off Sharlong, and Yoshizawa in fourth is definitely not going to be making the semi-final. Yang, a very sensible and clever skate from her. Dalament doing enough. And Sharlong will have to sit and wait. Well, what a really good quarterfinal this was as well. Once Yang hit the front, it was a case of, I'm staying there, I'm staying there, you're not going to get past me. Dalament bided her time, and when she attacked Yoshizawa, so then did Courtney Sharlong to take third place and give herself just a chance. Not sure that time of Sharlong's is going to be good enough, but Yang and Dalament are definitely through, and I don't think Sharlong is going to make it with that time of 1:33.71. That is slower than both Toshevsky and Omelchuk from the first two quarterfinals. So, quarterfinal number four features the silver medalist from the 1500 meters in Li Jinzi of the People's Republic of China. We're also going to see Jang Kyung Yun, the Seoul-born representative of the United States, who made the B final in the 1500 meters. Anna Falkowska, who's a very dangerous dark horse. Dora Shigeti of Hungary, a finalist in the 1500 meters. And Anastasia Astrakhantseva of Kazakhstan. Again, it's a strong quarterfinal. And away we go then with the lead of the People's Republic of China on the inside. Does not pick up top spot. That's going to be Astrakhantseva just with the early attack to hit the front here. And so we're seeing lots of jostling, and Lee decides, you know, I'm going to put myself back there. Seeing a lot of front running. That seems to be the tactic here as Zsigeti of Hungary decides to make her move. She's a very live contender as well, and Astrakhantseva is not going anywhere, is she? She continues to hold her front position here as Zsigeti looks to attack on the inside and does so really well of Astrakhantseva, who continues to hold her off, but Lee has not made any kind of attack here at all yet. Meanwhile, Zsigeti staying out of trouble. Falkowska can't get close, and Jang's having a tough time right at the back here. Now the attack is coming on the outside. And Falkowska's now taking closer order. She moves into third as Lee and the Hungarian Shigeti retain one and two. And Astrakhantseva is still in it as well, but Lee has hit the front as we get two laps to go. This is going to be a fascinating battle for second place, with Falkowska at the moment holding off Shigeti. But Lee, the silver medalist from the 1500 metres, looks comfortable here. It's going to be close for second, though. Falkowska. Oh, she's done a really good job there, Anna Falkowska, to take a strong second place. Dora Zsigeti will be checking to see if her time is going to be fast enough to book herself a third place finish. Well, I don't think it is. But no such worries for Lee Jinzi. And clever from Anna Falkowska. I described the Polish skater as a dark horse. We didn't see the best of her in the 1500 metres. She had a crash out, but prior to that crash out, she looked very, very capable. And we saw that again here. Lee was always expected to be the winner, having medalled in the 1500. But Falkowska stayed right with her and secured a very good second place. Shigeti in third might find herself run out of this. And that is confirmed. That time is not going to get her through. It's Lee Jinzi and Anna Falkowska who will advance to the semi-finals. So the qualifiers, and confirmed that our two third-place finishers, Polina Omelchuk and Paula Torshevsky, they will join this group in what will be a very strong field indeed for the semi-finals. Time now for the men to take centre stage in the 1,000-metre short track speed skating here in Gangwon at the Youth Winter Olympics. The Gangnyeong Ice Arena, which was built for the 2018 Winter Olympics, has seen some terrific skating so far, and that is only going to continue here. As we get to our first men's quarterfinal, it's Willem Murray of Great Britain, Peter Grossclose of the Philippines, Zhang Jinye of the People's Republic of China, Sean Schwei of the United States, and Nick Endeveld of the Netherlands, the beneficiary of a crash out. Right. He will be nearest us on the outside. The hot favourite will, of course, be Zhang, silver medalist in the 1500 metres, and he hits the front right from the get-go. Only two will advance as of right out of these quarterfinals. The top two third-place finishers, the fastest times, they'll also advance to the semi-finals, but you don't want to be playing that lottery. And certainly Zhang isn't taking any chances. He's gone out fast. Murray has stayed with him, but plenty of stuff going on behind the front two, and Grossclose has decided to take closer order, and he'll attack on the outside and try and take second place. Murray's held him off for now, but there's another attack coming as well, as Shuai is very much in this as well. He goes past Grossclose into second, the American who just missed out on a medal in the 1500 metres. So it's Murray, the British skater, flanked by Zhang, the silver medalist from the 1500 metres, and Shuai, the fourth place finisher in the 1500 metres. Grossclose is still very much in the mix as well here. And Murray now goes wide on the outside and takes a lovely attack there to hold second place off that bend. Zhang looks strong. Zhang looks comfortable and confident. It's Shuai that is in third place here as Grossclose has been run out of this. And Shuai takes a lovely attack on the inside off that final bend to secure a very clever second place. Timed that attack to perfection. Zhang was always away and clear. The battle for second was what was fascinating. And Shuai bided his time, bided his time. And when the man from Tulsa, Oklahoma decided to attack, his attack was perfect. Willem Murray of Great Britain, the long-time second-place skater, will have to wait and see if his time is fast enough to earn a semi-final berth. But Zhang dominated from the front. And given the caliber of these quarterfinals, you can't afford to play games. And a lot of these top skaters have just decided, we're going to hit the front. We're going to stay there and see if you can beat us. Grossclose had his attack. Murray held that off. Grossclose then faded. But when Shuai attacked off that last bend, he had timed it to perfection. Knew exactly what he was doing there, the young American. And that's good enough for second place. Murray at 1:27.931. We'll have to wait and hope that that is a fast enough time. Confirmation then, Zhang and Shuai, they're through to the 1,000-meter semi-final. Quarterfinal number two will feature Ju Jae-hee, the gold medalist from the 1,500 meters, and Yuta Fuchigami of Japan, Frank Tekam of France, Dominic Mayor of Hungary, and Asen Gurov of Bulgaria, who will be the outside of this field, but he skated very sensibly indeed in his heat. But this is a strong group again. Ju will be favourite. The battle for second probably will be between Fuchigami and Mayor. But Tekam, in his heat, the tall Frenchman, sat in second place all the way through, and he's immediately taken second place here as well, right behind Fuchigami. But that didn't last long, did it? Ju decided, right, I'm moving up as well, and so too is Mayor. And Tekam gets relegated to fourth. Gurioff is right at the back, and as smooth as you like goes Ju Jae-hee, hitting the front. Fuchigami right behind him, and then it's Mayor. And Tekam decides to have another attack on the inside, and it's Mayor that reads it, and he attacks on the outside, and that's putting Fuchigami under pressure, and the Hungarian does take second spot as the pace really picks up. Ju still comfortable and controlling it from the front. But real drama going on behind as Fuchigami attacks, and he can't get through again. Mayor holds him off, and Ju's been made to work. Now Fuchigami does get through, and a couple of metres gap has opened up, and then he slides out. Lost control completely, and Mayor now is comfortable in second place. Well, there will be a review, but I didn't see any bumps there. I think he's just lost it here, Fuchigami. And that's opened the door for Mayor. Ju, front runs. Mayor in a comfortable second place, and Tekam and Gurioff have never been able to get themselves into it. It's Ju Jae-hee who takes first place in this quarterfinal. Dominic Mayor in second. But that was a pressure fall for Yuta Fuchigami. That battle that was going on for second place with him and Mayor, it always produces little technical mistakes, and one little mistake at this level and you're going to slide out. And that's what happened to Fuchigami. We'll have to see a replay. I didn't see in real time any contact. I think he just lost it coming out of the bend. Ju couldn't care less. He didn't lose anything. He bossed it right from the front as we expected. Fuchigami had a little spell at the front, but Ju decided, you're not staying there. I'm going to get past you. And once he did, there was no way back. There he goes. He hit the front and he was going to stay there. That battle for second was always intriguing. And in the end, it rather fizzled out. Fuchigami on the outside there, still in it. And that battle with Mayor, he's held him off there, but they really are going here, and he's just lost it. Just lost it. Simple as that. One tiny little slip at this level, then you're sliding out. Tekam will take third place in a slow time of 1:30. And with any kind of contact like that, there will always be a referee check. But I'll be surprised if anything happens here. And the skaters coming out ready for quarterfinal number three, featuring the Serb Luka Jasic alongside Zhang Bohao of the People's Republic of China, Raito Kida of Japan, Victor Chartrand of Canada, and Christophe Madry, the beneficiary of a crash out. He got advanced, and he'll be in position number 5. Jasic, of course, had that crash out in the 1500 metres, but is healthy enough to be competing here in the 1000. Well, in position 2, it'll be Zhang Bohao of the People's Republic of China who will be the favourite out of this group, having reached the 1500-metre final. But it's Victor Chartrand who decides to be the pace setter, with Christophe Madry right alongside him. If those two are first and second at the finish of this one, I will be very, very surprised, but they've decided to set the tone here. Zhang will sit in third place with Kida in fourth, and both the two Asians now decide it's time to make the move. And Jasic of Serbia is bringing up the rear. But it is now, as we expect, Zhang front running with Kida in second place. And a big move from Jasic moves him up to third. The Serbian going past Chartrand. And it's Madry that has been relegated to fifth place here. Big attack comes round on from Kida on the outside there. He hits the front. Chartrand is taking closer order as well, trying to get past Jasic. Jasic is run out of third. Chartrand holds him off there. Zhang happy to stay in second place. It's Japan lead, though, with Kida and Zhang, and that gap's growing. Chartrand can't keep up with them. And at the moment, it's looking like Kida and Zhang have secured their place in the semi-final as they come off this final bend. And it's Zhang who will edge it ahead of Kida. Well, it was interesting to the midway point, and then Zhang and Kida, once they made their move, you kind of sense that the two Europeans and Chartrand, the Canadian, just were not going to get there. The time not particularly fast either, which is good news for Willem Murray of Great Britain, who I think is on the threshold of a fastest finish in third place, because Jasic finishing third here in not a particularly fast time. And Chartrand had to wave the white flag, having been very heavily involved. Just lost it around the bend, and he faded right out of the picture. But Zhang and Kida opened up that gap, and once you see 2 or 3 metres open up at this level, you just can't pull it back. Chartrand sliding out off that final lap, but was never in contention. He picked himself up to finish. Jasic at 130.192 will occupy the second best third place finish, but with one heat still to go. And the 5 quarterfinalists in quarterfinal number 4 are on the ice. They are Mohamed Bozdag of Turkey, Kim Yu-sung of the Republic of Korea, the 1500-meter bronze medalist, Daniele Zampedri, who won the B final in the 1500, Lucas Koo of Brazil, and Timeo Libaud of France, who got advanced after his no-fault crash out in the quarterfinals. Kim, of course, not only with home ice, but with the fact that he is a medalist from the 1500 metres, will be the favourite here. But we'll just get confirmation before we have our fourth quarterfinal. I think this should be a formality, but let's wait and see. So there will be a very, very short delay here. And whilst going back to this fourth quarter final, while Kim is going to be favoured, the battle for second spot between Bozdag, Zampedri and Koo looks wide open. Libaud, you would think, is making up the numbers, just happy to be here after that crash out. So let's see if Kim, in position 2 there, will just take it from the front. But he's got 3 skaters with him that have all got serious aspirations of a second place finish. Kim, it is, currently in second behind Koo, the early pace setter here, And then Kim decides, you know what? Let's take it from the front. Zampedri is in third place. Bozdan is in fourth. And Libo bringing up the rear and probably going to stay there. And similarly, Kim, the Korean, is probably going to stay right where he is here. It's the battle for second that is going to be absolutely fascinating. Bozdan makes a move to get himself past Zampedri. It's still Ku, the Brazilian, who looks strong and comfortable in second, but still five laps to go. Absolutely anything can happen here. Kim, comfortable and composed. Nobody's putting any pressure on him. Ku, very happy in his slipstream. Bozdan right behind him. Zampedri's got to close that gap down because the tall Italian can't be cut adrift. He's stayed close. And the 1-2-3-4 positions remain unchanged with Kim continuing the front run. Ku holds off Bozdan there as we get down to two laps to go. Bozdan's looking to attack on the inside. Ku shuts that down. Now Bozdan will have another go on the inside here, and Ku's got in ahead of him again. Still, Kim is comfortable. And Kim is skating well within himself. He's not going to be caught, but who's going to get second? Whoa, that was mighty close, wasn't it? I think Ku's done it. Bozdan was pushing him all the way. Bozdan's going to have to hope that he's got a shot at one of the third-place finishes there. Well, they just couldn't catch Kim, could they? I'm pretty sure it was Ku that held off the fast-finishing Mohamed Bozdan. But these Korean skaters are so well drilled, aren't they? And the game plan is so clear in these quarterfinals. Attack from the front and see if any of your opponents can challenge you and get past you. And Ku found that despite everything that was going on behind him, nobody was going to take him on. Nobody could take him on. Bozdan just could not find a way through. Lucas Ku held off a couple of attacks to secure himself a second place with Bozdan. Bozdan, though, at 1:27. I'm pretty sure that's going to be fast enough to, and that's confirmed. Bozdan is safely through to the semi-final. Zampedri is the man that misses out. And Willa Murray of Great Britain also confirmed as another one of the third place finishers. So these are the skaters that will advance to the semi-final. If you thought it was tough getting through the quarterfinals, good luck getting through the semi-finals, because that is a scarily strong group. So we're down to the semi-finals for the women and men. And that will be in around 15 minutes' time.
추운 날씨 속에서도 경기장을 찾아주신 여러분께 감사 인사를 전합니다. 바닥에 미끄러지고 있으니 입장하시는 관중 여러분께서는 안전에 신경 써주시길 바라겠습니다.
Please turn off your cell phone ringtones and camera flashes during the game. Please remember that the best spectator behavior makes for the best performance. So please give the athletes a round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, please take care of your belongings and if you find a lost item, please leave it with the nearest staff.
경기 중에는 휴대전화의 벨소리와 카메라의 플래시는 꺼주시길 바라겠습니다. 최상의 관중 매너가 최상의 경기력을 만든다는 건 잊지 말아주시고 선수들에게 아낌없는 박수도 부탁드리겠습니다. 관람객 여러분께서는 소식품 관리에 주의를 기울여주시고 분실물을 습득하셨다면 가까운 안내요원에게 맡겨주시길 바랍니다.
Visitors are asked to take care of their belongings and if you find a lost item, please leave it at the nearest stop. Also, please be aware that stairs and floors can be slippery. If you're experiencing an emergency or need assistance, please contact the staff immediately for assistance. Please also familiarize yourself with the emergency evacuation route in case of an emergency.
관중 여러분께서는 소지품 관리에 주의를 기울여주시고 분실물을 습득하셨다면 가까운 안내 요원에게 맡겨주시길 바라겠습니다. 또한 계단을 비롯한 바닥이 미끄러울 수 있으니 주의해 주시길 바라겠습니다. 만약 응급 상황이 발생했거나 도움이 필요한 관람객께서는 즉시 안내 요원에게 도움을 요청해 주시면 되겠습니다. 비상 상황에 대비해 비상 대피도 미리 알아주시길 바라겠습니다.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen. In just a moment, the 1,000-meter semifinals will begin at 1:14. The women's 1,000-meter semifinals will take place first, followed by the men's 1,000-meter semifinals at 1:23.
관중 여러분, 잠시 후 8시
잠시 후 여자 1000m 준결승전이 시작되겠습니다. 경기 관전을 위해서 관중 여러분께서는 자리로 돌아가 참석해 주시길 바라겠습니다. 준결승전은 준준결승전을 통과한 10명의 선수가 5명씩 2개조로 나눠서 결승 진출을 위한 대결을 벌이게 됩니다.
The finals will begin at 147 with the women's match and 157 with the men's match. There will be two finals, Final A and Final B. Final A is the medal deciding final, while Final B is a competition between athletes who didn't make it to Final A to determine the final record. So Final B will be the first to go, followed by Final A for the medals. Now the first semi-finalists, who are just one step away from the final, ready to enter the ice.
결승전은 오후 1시 47분부터 여자 경기가 열리고 1시 57분부터는 남자 경기가 열립니다. 파이널 A와 파이널 B로 나눠서 결승전이 치러집니다. 파이널 A는 메달을 결정하는
The skaters preparing to come out for these semi-finals in the 1,000 meters short track speed skating event for women. For the 10 athletes still remaining in the competition. So for the 10 skaters, a huge achievement just to get this far. So it's just now a question of whether they can take the next step. Only two of the five will advance by right to the final. The fastest third place finisher will also go through. Chung Jae-hee, Paula Torshevsky, Yang Jingru, Angel Dalaman and Anna Falkowska in this first semi-final. Yang of the People's Republic of China, the gold medalist from the 1500 metres, a final in which Chung Jae-hee crashed out. The three Europeans hoping to crash the party here as well. Dalaman, who underachieved in a disappointing 1500 metres, looking for a bit of redemption here in the 1000 metres. She will be very dangerous, and Falkowska has already proved herself a very capable skater. Torshevsky, the fastest third place finisher, completing this quintet.
Ready.
The first semi-final in the 1,000 metres for women underway then, and hitting the front is Chung of the host nation, but Yang makes an immediate move to sneak into second place, so the three Europeans already playing catch-up here. It's Dalaman that will be in third place. The Dutch skater. But we've seen from the Korean skaters through the competition that they're not taking any chances through these stages. They're skating from the front and looking to try and skate the race out of the skaters behind them. Yang is happy to sit in second place, knowing that Dalaman is behind her, and then Yang makes the move and attacks on the inside and just goes past. So Chung now is under pressure from Dalaman. And there's a crash, and it's Dalaman that goes with Chung. Now that was going to open it up as Falkowska suddenly pops up as a top contender. She moves into second place ahead of Torshevsky. Well, Yang stayed out of trouble, and it's more trouble for Angel Dalaman, who's just had so many problems in the competition here in Gangwon. But Falkowska, who also had a crash in the 1500 metres, is a beneficiary this time. She sits in second place, and I don't think Torshevsky, the German, is going to be able to catch them as we come to the final lap. There will, of course, be a review, but Yang of China and is joined by Falkowska of Poland in the final. Well, real drama there as Chung and Dalaman are coming together, and Dalaman, who's had no luck at all in this competition so far, out of luck again. And this is one for the referee to adjudicate. There will be a look at whether there's a penalty, whether there's an advance to come as a result of this crash. Let's see if we can have a look at it. Yang stayed out of trouble. So too did Falkowska. Yang decided time to hit the front. And that was such a good move because Dalamant decided to put some pressure on Chung. And it's Chung that slides out. And Dalamant might get a break here. She's definitely taken out of it. There's no way Chung is going to survive that replay review. I think she's done. But the question is whether Dalamant will get an advance. Yang and Falkowska, they don't have to worry about any of this. But looking at that replay, and remember, doesn't matter what I see, doesn't matter what you see, it's what the referee sees here. That is going to be the key determination. Now, the question is Angel Dalamant going to get a break? Chung certainly under pressure lost it. She had the crash out in the 1500 meter final as well. So that's another disappointment for her. As we just take another look from a different angle, and it's all very congested, isn't it? Very congested, as Yang has got the front position there, and she's just run out of space, lost it completely, and takes Dalamant out with her. But what's the referee's ruling going to be on this? Well, Yang is perfectly entitled to hold that position. I don't think this is going to involve her at all. Couldn't see her doing anything wrong. But he's made his decision. He is now confirming that decision with the scoring table, and it will be confirmed for us. Oh, no. Yes, it is going to be confirmed. Well, look at that. Dalamant is allowed to advance. Toshevsky and Chung will be in the B final. Dalamant have done nothing wrong, and that is confirmed. So some drama there. And, there's going to be more drama here as we get ready for our second semi-final. Kang Min-ji flying the host nation flag. Diana Vegi, Ocean Gerard, who's skated brilliantly to get here. Polina Omelchuk and Li Jin-zi of the People's Republic of China. Li will be the favoured skater here, the 1500-metre semi-finalist. Kang will be hoping to make it through for the host nation, and Vegi, the Hungarian, who just finished an agonising fourth in the 1500-metre, will certainly have plenty to say. Omelchuk and Gerard bringing up the rear here. And an early gap opens up as the attack comes in from Kang. So Kang hits the front, and then Li sits in just behind her, and all eyes are on the Hungarian, Vegi, in third place. Omelchuk decides to have a go on the inside and gets into third place. She reached the 1500-meter final. She is no mug. And the two Europeans having a real battle here, trying to catch the two Asians. And at the moment, it's Kang that leads the way. And Li is still comfortable in second place, but the two Europeans are right in the thick of this as well, with the Hungarian Vegi hitting the front and really setting a fast tempo here as well. It's Li that stays with her. We've lost Kang, who's crashed out. So that gasp you heard was a result of that. Omelchuk in third place, trying to take closer order here as Li continues to hold off Vegi. Omelchuk right in there as well, and Gerard skating well and trying to attack on the inside here, the Canadian. It's bunched, and it's Omelchuk that sneaks second, does she? There was a real stretch at the line there, and this is going to go to a photo finish. Li wins it, but who's got second? Well, Omelchuk and Vegi, that's going to take some separating. Kang, well, she's getting a lot of sympathetic applause. But the big story here is that there will be no Korean skater in the 1,000-meter final. Well, everything's looking okay here, isn't it? He's comfortable. She's in control. And then as the attack started to come, and it's Omelchuk putting the pressure on, and then she just loses it. Simple as that. That opened the door. And whilst Lee held first place, it was going to be a question of which of the two Europeans could steal it. That was a big stretch from Vagy. That might just be enough, you know, from Vagy. Oh, that's going to be mighty close. Oh. Oh, that is unbelievable. Omelchuk by a whisker. 0.03 of a second. And Diana Vagy, who missed out on a medal by a whisker in the 1500 metres, doesn't even make the final here. But Polina Omelchuk, who did make the final in the 1500 metres, the Kazakhstan skater does it again. Angel Dalaman gets advanced. Anna Falkova is also in there. And the B finalists will feature the two Korean skaters. What drama in the women's 1000 metre semi-finals. Attention now turns to the men's 1,000 metre semi-finals. Two skaters from the People's Republic of China in the two Zhangs, Zhang Xinjie and Zhang Bohao, and Sean Shuai of the United States will be the favourites, Willem Murray and Dominic Maior, the two Europeans here, hoping to get in amongst them. But immediately, we've got Zhang Xinjie, who picked up a silver medal in the 1500 metres. He hits the front here. Zhang Bohao looks to try and come up and join him. And it's a fast start. Shuai, comfortable in fourth place at the moment. And he just actually drops down to fifth as Murray, who's had a really good skate so far, looks to attack on the outside. That's tracked by Maior as well, the two Europeans in third and fourth. Murray sneaking into third as well, but it's the Zhang-Zhang partnership in front. The two Chinese skaters, Zhang Bohao and Zhang Xinjie, leading the way with Murray in third place. But we know Sean Shuai has got a sprint finish and he will attack. And does indeed attack here into third place. It's Maior that now smooths his way into fourth as Murray drops back down to fifth. But Zhang leads Zhang. Maior taking a very, very tight line there as Shuai just bullied him out of it. And Maior lost all his momentum and he's done. He's out of it. Shuai tracking Zhang Xinjie and Zhang Bohao. Now, can he have the sprint finish? Can he get in? No, he can't. He'll have to wait and see if that third place finish is going to be a quick enough time. But Zhang Xinjie and Zhang Bohao, it's a 1-2 Chinese double. We'll be seeing both of them in the final. Sean Shuai will have to wait now and watch the second semi-final. He was so strong. It was his physicality, Shuai, that he saw off that challenge from Maior. He lost all his momentum. Murray ended up in fourth, but this was a very strong skate. He really worked well in partnership as well to keep Shuai at bay. Shuai's time will await the official confirmation, but unofficially it's around 1:26.55. But even he, a strong finisher, just could not get in front of Zhang Bohao in second place. Well, whenever there's any kind of contact, of course it has to be reviewed. And Shuai and Maior definitely had a coming together. Whether that's going to see anything overturned here, we're going to see a penalty or anything like that. I can't see an advance, but the possibility of a penalty, depending on the referee's adjudication, of course. Well, he's seen what he needs to see. His ruling is being relayed to the scorer's table. And then it will be officially relayed to everybody else. This is interesting. That's a conversation. That's not just a, yeah, everything's okay, let's move on. I wonder what we're going to see here. Well, let's take a look. Let's find out. Oh, Shuai is indeed penalised. Well, he was very physical with Mayor. It doesn't affect the top two, but it throws a lifeline to Willem Murray. In third place, he might have a shot at the final here. Sean Shuai does not have a shot at the final. He is penalised. And as soon as I saw that conversation going on, I thought, there's trouble brewing here. So semi-final number one is done. Semi-final number two features Kim Yo-sung of the Korean Republic, Lucas Ko of Brazil, Mohamed Bozdag of Turkey, Joo Jae-hee of Korea, and Reito Kida of Japan. It's a strong group, featuring the bronze and gold medalists from the 1500 meters. And Kida of Japan also made that final, as did Bozdag. So the Brazilian Lucas Ko will be the underdog here, and he looks like he couldn't care less. He's decided to go from the front. Ko immediately jumps out fast. They know, all these skaters will know, there's the possibility of a third place finish that will be good enough. But Ko then gets overtaken by Kim. We're seeing an attack as well coming in from Ju, the 1500 meter gold medalist, and the two Koreans hit the front. Ko run out into third and then gets bumped and knocked out of it. Now that's a clear foul, I think, there from Bozdag, who drops back himself. So it's a Korea 1-2 with Reito Kida of Japan in third place, but there's going to be some decisions to be made here, because that looked for all the world like Bozdag just wiped out Lucas Ko. He's carried on skating, but he's not going to get there. Meanwhile, it's Kida that has split the two. Kim leads with Ju in third place, and can Aita stay there as well? Bozdag has made terrific ground up, but surely has left it too late. Here comes the attack, but still it's going to be Kida holding off second place, and that's Kim Yoo-sung. And Joo Jae-hee coming through very, very strongly right at the death as Kim Yoo-sung faded. And Bozdag came steaming in as well, but I think he might be in a bit of trouble anyway. Kida just wouldn't be denied. I mean, it was all going on in that semi-final. Kim Yoo-sung, who led and led and led. Here he is, comfortable. And there is Joo Jae-hee coming around the outside. And they take first and second place. There's that nudge from Bozdag that takes out Ko. Meanwhile, it's Joo that now hits the front as Kim Yoo-sung runs out of gas. And it's Kida that will take second spot. Bozdag with the third place finish, but as I say, he might be in hot water here anyway. There's a possibility we could even see Ko advance. Yeah, plenty to look at here. I think we can say for certain that Kim Yoo-sung, the bronze medalist from the 1500 metres, we will not be seeing him in the 1000 metre final. He'll have to settle for the B final. All these skaters through the semi-final will skate again, either in the A or the B final. But of course, you want to be skating for a medal. William Murray of Great Britain, the third place finisher in semi-final number one with a time of 127.9. He's waiting to see the outcome of this, but there's the shove. Now, that's no blame on Ko. He is shoved by Bozdag, who I'm sure is going to be penalised for that. So his third place finish will probably be irrelevant. But clear contact on the Brazilian, who may be advanced to the final as a result of that. But that's a decision for this man right here. And generally speaking, as we know, the longer the review, the more likelihood of a decision. If it's a wave off, it's a pretty easy decision. This is not getting waved off. And I don't think this is going to be good news for Mohamed Bozdag of Turkey. But could it be good news for Lucas Ko of Brazil? It's good news if you're on the big screen. You've been seen around the world. Mixed emotions for these fans, with one of their skaters through and one definitely not through. But at least they will be represented in the 1,000 metres final. And meanwhile, the conversations continue here. And it's not been a good day on the short track speed skating for the host nation. No representation in the women's final and only one representative in the men's final. But we'll await official confirmation of all of that, which comes right here. And it's going to be Bozdag who gets away with it and a fast enough time to put him into the final. Jujehi and Raito Kida, one and two. And it's Mohamed Bozdag who will join them in the medal final. So there we go. This is our potential medalists. Two from the People's Republic of China, one from Japan. Jujehi, the gold medalist in the 1500. And Bozdag. And in the B final, it's Ko, Murray, Mayor, and Kim Yusung. So the ice will be dressed ahead of our finals.
Thank you to all the spectators who joined us at the stadium despite the cold weather. We would like to remind spectators to be safe as the floor can be slippery. If there is an emergency or visitors need assistance, we ask that they contact the staff immediately for assistance.
추운 날씨 속에서도 경기장을 찾아주신 관중 여러분께 감사 인사를 드립니다. 바닥이 미끄러울 수도 있으니 입장하시는 관중 여러분께서는 안전에 신경을 써주시길 바라겠습니다. 만약 응급 상황이 발생했거나 도움이 필요한 관람객께서는 즉시 안내 요원에게 도움을 요청해 주시면 되겠습니다. 경기 중에는 휴대전화의 벨소리와 카메라의 플래시도 꺼주시길 바라겠습니다. 최상의 관중 매너가 최상의 경기력을 만든다는 것 잊지 말아주시고 선수들에게 아낌없는 박수도 부탁드리겠습니다. 관중 여러분께서는 소식품 관리에 주의를 기울여주시고 분실물을 선택하셨다면 가까운 안내 요원에게 맡겨주시길 바라겠습니다.
attention, ladies and gentlemen. Just a few moments starting at 1:47, the women's 1,000-meter final will take place. The 10 athletes who made it to the final after fierce competition will be competing for medals, and the women's race will be followed immediately by the men's race.
관중 여러분, 잠시 후 1시 47분부터 여자 1000m 결승전이 열립니다. 치열한 경쟁 끝에 결승전에 올라온 10명의 선수가 메달을 얻고 경기를 벌이는데요. 여자 경기에 이어서 남자부 경기도 곧바로 이어질 예정입니다. 박릉 아이스아레나 선정되고 있는 2023 강원 동계 조선 올림픽 대회 쇼트트랙 경기를 함께하고 계십니다. 쇼트트랙 경기 재밌게 보고 계십니다.
Finals time, and no medals at stake for these five skaters, but classification points are on the line. Representing Germany is Paula Tortsevsky. Representing Hungary, Diana Vegi. For Canada is Ocean Gerard, and surprisingly, two Korean skaters in this B final, Chung Jae-hee and Kang Min-ji.
Final B, in position number one, Germany.
Yes, Paula Tortsevsky has always found a way to get through. Came through as one of the fastest losers, and here she is skating in the B final. Diana Vegi, who just missed out on the medal in the 1500 metres, a fourth place finish for her. She'd be disappointed to be skating in a B final. Ocean Gerard, I'm sure, will be absolutely delighted. One of the next gen team for Canada, training out of Montreal. Done really well to get here. Chung Jae-hee has had no luck, having crashed out in the final of the 1500 metres.
Republic of Korea.
And back-to-back B finals for Kang Min-ji as well. There's no medals on the line, but they are competitors. And all five of them will want to win this B final, be in no doubt about that.
Ready.
And away we go then. Will it be a Korea 1-2 straight off the first bend? Well, it's a Korea 1-3. Vegi looks to try and take closer order here as well. He's getting past Tortsevsky. Vegi will certainly want some consolation for not being in the final. Well, she's taken a strong second place here. It's Chung leading them around. It's Korea 1-3. Or no, it's other. Tortsevsky is in third place. With Chung down, Kang rather, excuse me, down in fourth place. And Gerard trying to make a move, but she's still stuck at the back of the field here. It remains Chung Jae-hee in first place with Vegi breathing down her neck. And the German Tortsevsky continuing to threaten. Nobody's made a move yet as we get down to three laps to go. Here comes a move. Here comes an attack on the outside from Kang. She moves up to third and now up to second. Or can she get past? She does get past Vegi. It's Korea hitting the front, first and second. And a big, big, big move this as we get the bell. And Kang Min-ji has gone from fourth to first and is running away from this field. And it looks like she's going to get the consolation prize of the B first place finish. Her compatriot Chung Jae-hee holds off Diana Vegi in second. The Hungarian will have to settle for third. Well, Kang Min-ji timed that attack to perfection. Just sat in fourth place, happy to sit there. But when she went, it was a powerful move, and none of her rivals could find an answer to it. Very comfortable in fourth place. Just watching what was going on in front of her. But then when she decided to make the move, it was a strong and determined one. And that attack round that bend was a backbreaker. So confirmation how the B final has finished. It's a 1-2 for the Republic of Korea. Kang Chung Vegi of Hungary taking third place. Torshevsky and the very impressive just to get that far, Océan Guérard of Canada completing the field. Time now for our medal final here in the women's 1,000 metre event at the Gangneung Ice Arena. And it is Yang Jingru, the gold medalist from the 1,500 metres. Anna Falkowska of Poland. Li Jinzi, the silver medalist in the 1,500 metres. Polina Omelchuk and Angel Dalleman of the Netherlands, who got that reprieve. And of the three Europeans, she will probably be the biggest threat. In position number one, it's Yang Jingru, who had that extraordinary 1,500 metre final win. If you haven't seen it, go find it.
In position number two, Poland.
Really good to see Anna Falkowska make this final. She was very, very unlucky to crash out in the 1,500 metres. A very clever and very smooth skater.
In position number three, People's Republic of China.
Confirmation of our second skater from the People's Republic of China. It's the silver medalist from the 1,500 metres, Li Jinzi.
In position number four,
what a great tournament she's had. Made the final of the 1,500 metres. Made the final of the 1,000 metres.
In position number five, Netherlands.
Openly, Netherlands.
Angel Dalleman.
And really good to see Angel Dalleman here as well. She had no luck at all in the 1,500 metres. Had a no-fault crash out in the semi-final. Got that reprieve. And she is probably the biggest threat to the two Chinese skaters, as you would expect for a final in an Olympic event. It's a very strong field indeed. It's a huge achievement just to get this far, but when you have got this far, how you want to go home with a medal. It's Yang on the inside.
Go to the start. Ready.
So Yang on the fifth, on the inside, the gold medalist from the 1500, with Li, the silver medalist. But it looks like we're going to see leading from the get-go is Angel Dalleman, the Dutch skater who's tall and powerful. And she's not going to let the two Chinese skaters have this all their own way. Falkowska is in third place, with Omelchuk taking closer order as well as we get through the first lap in this 1,000-metre final. Still, it's Dalleman leading the way. The Dutch have never medaled in junior Winter Olympic speed skating, youth Winter Olympic speed skating. Can they get a medal here? The two Chinese skaters in second and fourth. Falkowska between them. Omelchuk of Kazakhstan continuing her watching brief at the back of the field. Here comes the first attack. And it's Yang, the potential double gold medalist, and Dalamant saying, no, you're not having it all. And we're seeing an attack on the inside. Falkowska makes a move on the inside, and there's a bump, and two go down, including one of the Chinese skaters. And it's Omelchuk that stands up as well. It's Yang that's still there. Omelchuk in second. And are we going to get this waved off? Yes, we are. Press the reset button. One of the skaters is slow getting up. And in that situation, you have to stop it. Well, that was drama. It was Dalaman again involved in the collision. I mean, how many times has that happened for her? And here she is again. She's had absolutely no luck at all. Just clipping Falkowska there and taking Lee with her. Don't see any blame attached to the Polish skater there at all. Oh, I tell you, she's had a lot of luck in this Youth Winter Olympics, and all of it has been bad. And that looks like another one for Angel Dalamant. Hopefully she's okay. Didn't see a foul there. Referee's having a look. Lee just got taken out. So it's collateral damage. And now the referee's... Dalamant actually looks okay. Talking to the paramedics there, but does not look in particular distress. I'm sure if it was a paramedic, actually, a member of the medic, coaching team there, I think. But physically looked okay. Yang, Omelchuk, and Falkowska must have thought, hey, we're in the medals, only for the race to be called off. Never seen a skater from Poland or Kazakhstan medal in the short track speed skating. This is the fourth edition of the speed skating at the Youth Winter Olympics. Drama here and an adjudication to be made. And let's see what it is. There's a chance we'll see them just all going again. I think that's what we're gonna get, unless something goes against Dalaman. Let's wait and see. Well, we've got a nod, we've got a thumbs up. So we've had the decision. Yeah, it's Angel Dalaman. Would you believe it? She's got the penalty. Well, what else can go wrong for her? It's not a bad decision. She's just unlucky. She stumbled and she'll know it. She'll know it, but she'll still be absolutely devastated. Tough break for Dalaman. But that's sport, isn't it? The breaks go your way, the breaks go against you. It means, at the very least now, even if the two Chinese skaters would be expected to be gold and silver, there will be a first ever speed skating medal for either Poland or Kazakhstan here. With Dalaman out, it's Yang, Falkowska, Lee, and Omelchuk. Four in our final.
Ready.
The women's 1,000 meter final begins with just the four skaters, and it's Yang who will lead her compatriot Lee around a very slow and steady opening lap here. Polina Omelchuk of Kazakhstan is tracked by Anna Falkowska of Poland. And that's our 1-2-3-4. With no speed, no tempo at the moment, but Yang looking to be a double gold medalist here. Lee, who picked up the silver medal behind her compatriot, who had that extraordinary medal, gold medal run in the 1500 meters. She still leads. It's a 1-2 for the People's Republic of China as Polina Omelchuk stays in third place, and it's Anna Falkowska bringing up the rear here as we wait for somebody to make a move. The pace picks up, but nobody makes any kind of a move so far. Omelchuk closing in on Lee here. I might look to attack. No, she doesn't. She's happy just to bide her time here. And Falkowska's biding her time as well in fourth place. Yang's still looking very, very comfortable. And the pace really does pick up now, and Lee decides to head for the hills. She takes first place. Yang in second place. Omelchuk still in third as Falkowska tries to take closer order. But it is Lee Jinzi who leads as we take the bell here. It's going to be a 1-2 for the Chinese skaters. Omelchuk continues to hold off Falkowska in third place. And it's gold for Lee Jinzi. Silver for Yang Jingru. And what a bronze medal for Polina Omelchuk as well for Kazakhstan. Well, Chinese women continuing to dominate here in the speed skating competition. And it's these two that are gold and silver again. This time, it's a reverse of the 1500 meters. It's Lee who takes gold, Yang who takes silver. But what about that for Polina Omelchuk as well? A hugely impressive bronze medal. Well, she did well to make the final of the 1500 meters. She was a surprise finalist there. She's consolidated that with a bronze, but once again, it's the People's Republic of China that are dominating the women's events here. Back-to-back gold and silvers for Yang Jingru and Lee Jinzi. Double delight for them. Well, it was a play it again final, wasn't it? After the first one had to be stopped, and Omelchuk in third place was having her own duel with Falkowska, who just never managed to mount any kind of attack, and in the end it was easy for third place. And Lee Jinzi securing gold, and right behind her, her teammate, and they don't look too unhappy about it. Lee takes the gold. Yang takes the silver for the People's Republic of China. Polina Omelchuk with Kazakhstan's first ever short track speed skating medal at the Youth Winter Olympics. Our attention turns now to the men. And it will be final B. Kim Yoo-sung, who had a bronze medal in the 1500s, but ran out of steam in the last lap of his semi-final. He's joined by Willem Murray of Nottingham, who was the flag bearer for his country in the opening ceremony. Dominic Major of Hungary will be in his second B final. And the crash out victim, Lucas Ko, representing Brazil. What an achievement for him to be on this stage.
Go to the start. Red.
The B final for the men's 1,000 meters short track speed skating underway, and it's Lucas Ko who decides to set the pace here. And he is followed closely by Kim Yoo-sung of Korea. with Murray in third place and Major, who was happy to sit at the back in the semi-final, the Hungarian repeating the trick here. Rankings, points important. This is, and it's just competition as well at this level. So they've got this far. They are competitors. They're going to want to win every time they're on the ice. Nice little move taken there by Kim, who will really want to win this race in front of his own fans. Major looking to take closer order, and there was a little clip there. Murray rather lost some ground and have had to make it up very, very quickly as Ko now sits in second place behind Kim. Ko tries to get in front there, but Kim's not going to let him through. And now Ko's going to attack on the inside as well, as is Major. And Kim is run out of that. Ko hits and heads for home here with Major in pursuit. Kim in third place still looks dangerous. Murray's got an awful lot of work to do, but Ko is strong as he hears the bell as well. This is Ko's race to lose. Major looking to close the gap on him. Kim doesn't look like he's got anything left in the tank as well. It's going to come down to the final, and it's just Lucas Ko that hangs on as an almost out of control Dominic Major struggles to get over the line. Kim Yoo-sung will take third place, but what a wonderful achievement that is for Lucas Ko representing Brazil. He will finish his 1,000-meter campaign on a high, winning in the B final and holding off the determined challenge of Major. Off that last bend to do so, Major really attacked on the inside. That might be something that the referee is looking at. And I don't think there's any doubt about our winner. And I can't see it, him being the victim of a penalty. Well, we've had drama in the men's competition throughout, and we've even had it in this B final. It's a strong and determined run from Ko, wasn't it? And again, it was Kim Yoo-sung who looked like he was going to be strong, but when he was attacked, he found no response. And just as in his semi-final, here's Major really going for it. And as he stayed on. That's going to be worth a look or two, isn't it? There's confirmation. It's Ko that's penalised. Major will take it. Well, well, well. Well. Well, the referee will have seen something. And whatever he saw, it's not a happy ending for Lucas Ko. But who is going to be walking away with the medals as we look at our start list for the final of the men's 1,000 metres? Led out by Joo Jae-hee of the Korean Republic, the 1,500-metre gold medalist. He's going to be followed by Raito Kida of Japan, making his second consecutive final.
Position number three, Turkey.
Somebody, Turkey.
Mohamed Mostar.
And talking about consecutive finals, that's a feat that's also been achieved by Mohamed Bozdag. And it's the silver medalist from the 1,500 metres, looking confident, Zhang Jingzhe.
In position number five, People's Republic of China.
And rounding out our quintet, another finalist from the 1,500 metres, it's Zhang Bohao of the People's Republic of China. What a strong-looking lineup this is. Featuring our gold and silver medalists from the 1500 metres. Zhu from the host nation, Zhang Jinzhe, from the People's Republic of China. They will, of course, both be favoured here. But Bozdag, Zhang Bohao, and Raito Kida will all be dreaming that this is their moment to pick up an Olympic medal.
Right.
Away we go then, the men's 1,000-metre short track speed skating final. And immediately we're seeing a big attack from Zhang Jingye, who tracks in right behind Zhu Jiehe, with Raito Kida of Japan in third place, but not anymore because the other Zhang, Bohao, has come around as well. And now we've seen a crash out. Bozdag is in there and it's the Korean that's gone, and we are going to have to redo this one. Well, Zhu Jiehe sliding out. Will he get a reprieve here? That is now the question. That's what they're all hoping. He's certainly hoping that. Well, let's have a closer look at what happened here. Well, there he is. And is he clipped for it? I tell you, if he gets a reprieve, he's very fortunate. He's done. I mean, that's nothing there. Well, what a difference 24 hours can make. This time yesterday, Zhu Jiehe was skating his way to a 1500 meter gold here. It looks like his shot at a second medal is going to end in disappointment. And it's going to make the Chinese delegation feel even more confident of a 1-2 finish here. But let's see what the referee has to say. There's Zhu Jiehe. So the wait goes on, not for much longer, hopefully.
Getting ready for the race.
So we will have our restart. And Ju Jae-hee will get a reprieve here. He's on the inside. Right. Let's see what happens this time then. Ju comes off the first bend, tracked by Zhang Jingzhe, with Kida in third place for Japan. And yeah, really controlled that bend very, very well there, Ju. The 1-2-3-4-5 stays exactly as it was. It's Mohamed Bozdan right at the back for Turkey. Still no change in the order, but here comes an attack on the outside, and it's a strong one as well from Zhang Jingzhe. But he takes top spot as well now. And Zhang Bohao with a nice move as well. And down he goes again. Ju Jae-hee gets taken out by the two Chinese skaters. Zhang Bohao, I think it was, that got him. And the race goes on this time. It's the People's Republic of China, 1 and 2, right? Okida is in third place, and now he's overtaken, though, by Bozdag. Oh, what drama we're seeing here with Zhang Bohao front-running against Zhang Jingzhe. Bozdag trying to hold off Kida as we take the bell. But this is looking like another 1-2 for the People's Republic of China. Zhang Bohao leading Zhang Jingzhe and Mohamed Bozdag. Those are our medalists. Well, because there was a crash, there will be a review. And there was certainly contact. But Zhang Bohao, at the moment, thinks he's got himself a gold. Mohamed Bozdag, representing Turkey, a first ever medal for that nation. And look at what it means to the Turkish delegation. What a huge achievement from him. But it's another 1-2 for the People's Republic of China. Zhang Bohao, Zhang Jingzhe, settling for a second silver. Zhang Bohao, who did not make the podium with a fifth place finish in the 1500 meters, has more than made up for that here with top spot. But I think he was the skater who had the contact with Ju Jae-hee, and that is what the referee will be looking at. Well, Ju decided to attack from the front, and again was caught up in the drama, wasn't he, as Zhang Jingzhe goes past him. And Kida skating well at this point, but there, well, I don't think there's any contact. I think he's just lost it again. That was Zhang Bohao closest, but I don't think they can penalise him for that, surely. A golden smile for Zhang Bohao. And Ju Jae-hee, who was fortunate to even be in that restart, now sliding out again. And what does the referee see, if anything? Official confirmation still awaited here. Well, he sees what he needs to see, and he will communicate that at the scoring table. And then the world will know the official destination of the medals in the men's 1,000 metres. Well, one more look at it. His own skates. I think he was kind of put off by the attack round that outside from Bohao. They've penalised Bohao. Oh, my goodness. Wow, what drama in the men's 1,000 metres final. Zhang Bohao, who thought he'd got gold, is penalised for that contact with Zhu Jiehe. And it means that it's a gold medal instead for Zhang Jinzhe. Mohamed Bozdag will take the silver, and Raito Kida will take the bronze. A dramatic end to day two at the speed skating, which is not over yet. In just a few moments' time, we will have the medal presentations.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs va commencer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony will begin.
잠시 후 메달 시상식을 진행할 예정입니다.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du patinage de vitesse sur piste courte, 1000 mètres femmes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the short track speed skating, women's 1000 meters.
여러분, 지금부터 쇼트 트랙 스피드 스케이팅 1000m 여자 부분의 메달 시상식을 시작하겠습니다.
Time now then for our first ceremony of the day. What a moment. For the three medalists in the women's 1,000 meters.
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
Please welcome the medalists.
여러분, 메달리스트들을 환영해 주십시오.
So here come our medalists then. It's a familiar journey for the two Chinese skaters. They've been here before. Again.
Les médailles seront remises par
The medals will be presented by
메달 시상자를 소개하겠습니다.
Monsieur John Cox, vice-président du Comité international olympique.
Vice President of the International Olympic Committee.
국제 올림픽 위원회 부위원장.
Accompanied by
다음은 시상품 수상자입니다.
Monsieur Thibaut Fauconnet, athlète modèle de l'Union Internationale de Patinage Olympien.
ISU athlete role model Olympian.
국제 빙상 경기 연맹 롤 모델 올림피언.
Médaillé de bronze, Kazakhstan.
Bronze medalist, Kazakhstan.
동메달리스트, Kazakhstan, Polina Omelchuk.
Oh, what a wonderful bronze medal that is for Polina Omelchuk. A finalist in the 1500 meter. A medalist in the 1000 meter. Kazakhstan's first ever medalist in the Youth Winter Olympic Short Track Speed Skating. Stone moment for her.
Médaillé d'argent, République populaire de Chine.
Silver medalist, People's Republic of China.
은메달리스트, 중국, 양진루.
It's the second medal then for Yang Jingru, who had that stunning gold medal in the 1500 meters and adds to the collection with silver in the 1000 meters.
médaillée d'or et championne des Jeux Olympiques de la Jeunesse, République Populaire de Chine.
Gold medalist and Youth Olympic Games champion, People's Republic of China.
금메달리스트, 청소년 올림픽 챔피언, 중국 리 진주.
A second medal too for Li Jinzi of the People's Republic of China. Silver behind her compatriot in the 1500 meters. Today, in the 1000 meters, it's gold.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de la République populaire de Chine.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of People's Republic of China.
여러분, 중국의 국가 연주가 있겠습니다. 모두 일어나 주시길 바라겠습니다.
Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés des Jeux Olympiques de la Jeunesse.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Youth Olympic Games medalists.
여러분, 청소년 올림픽 메달리스트 선수들입니다.
And that's the photo. Now these are the memories that will live forever for these young Olympic medalists.